folks. My name is Matthew Huchteman. I am a master's student here at the University of Missouri under Andrew Thomas. And today I'll be telling you a little bit about my graduate research project, which is a comprehensive evaluation of weed management methods for use in American elderberry production. So American elderberry as a specialty crop is fairly young in terms of development. It's been developed over the last three decades as a commercial crop. There are still a lot of areas in American elderberry production that require more basic research. One of those areas is weed management. So producers have done a very good job of looking to similar small fruit crops such as blackberry, blueberry, and raspberry in finding some weed management options that might work well for them. A couple of treatments that are featured in this study that American elderberry producers often employ that are found in other small fruit crops are woven fabric and wood chip mulch. We see those pretty often in American elderberry production. Producers can look at literature from other small fruit crops to gain insight as to how American elderberry may perform with some of these different weed management treatments, but really we can't say for certain how American elderberry will respond to some of these more commonly applied weed management treatments, as well as some that maybe could have potential but aren't widely applied by producers. So that's the idea of the study, is to sort of build a foundation to how to help producers understand how American elderberry perform under some of our different weed management treatments, as well as how weed ecology is affected by these treatments. This study also includes a partial budget analysis, which will help to provide some insight as to how each of these treatments performs in terms of economics. So the partial budget analysis includes costs that are different between treatments, including cost of materials and equipment, as well as labor cost, and then yield from each of the different treatment by variety combinations is included as well. This study is a factorial experiment with a mixed randomized design. If there's any researchers or statisticians out there who are listening, if you're not a researcher or a statistician, basically the project has four different factors. The first is weed management treatment, and that's the main one that we're interested in looking at. My weed management treatments, which I'll detail more here in a minute, are woven fabric, wood chip mulch, a more experimental cover crop option, herbicide, and then I have an unmanaged and a weed-free control as well. So that's the first factor, the weed management treatment. The second factor is cultivar. I have three different American elderberry varieties in the study, which are Rogersville, Pocahontas, and Bob Gordon. The third factor in the study is site. So today we're here at the University of Missouri's Horticulture and Agroforestry Research Farm. I have a second site just like this one at MU's Southwest Research Extension and Education Center in Mount Vernon, Missouri. The fourth factor in the study is year. So I conducted data collection in 2023, and that's mainly what we'll be talking about today as we get into some results. This year in 2024, I'm conducting the same data collection again, and I do have some information that includes both years. All right, so in terms of weed management treatment, they're kind of the star of the show. I like to discuss them in a little bit more detail. Our first treatment is a woven fabric. This is a permeable, durable woven fabric. It's a DeWitt Sunbelt woven fabric. It's 3 feet wide and it has a 10-year durability rating. So it's a little bit different than some of your annual horticultural plastics, which some producers do employ. We don't have an annual horticultural plastic in this study. Instead, we went with a more durable ground cover. Keep in mind as we discuss results for this treatment, in January of 2023, we split this fabric down the middle completely to allow plants to sucker and form a more competitive hedgerow. What we'll see with that is we have some higher ratings for weed biomass as a result. So opening up that fabric has proved to be a little bit problematic for us, and we'll discuss that more as we start to get into our results. The second treatment in the study is a wood chip mulch. This is just a rough hardwood mulch. Generally it comes from the electric cooperative. My initial application on the mulch was 4 inches in January of 2022, and following that each spring I do a 2-inch reapplication. So I put on 2 inches of fresh mulch each spring. My third treatment is a cover crop option. This one is a little bit more experimental, and we'll see that as we start to look at some of our results. We've still got some work to do on the cover crop treatment, but in October of each year, I sow oats in the cover crop plots. And I should mention my research plots are 4 feet wide by 16 feet long, and each one contains four American elderberry plants. So for the cover crop option, I broadcast oats in October, and I generally just broadcast those into existing residue. I use a high seeding rate, and they're able to germinate well. And then I let the oats overwinter. I initially had planned on the oats winter terminating for me, but the last 2 years, despite having some fairly cold spells in our winters here in Missouri, the oats did not terminate. So they did offer some competition in the spring before effectively terminating in June. I wanted this to be an option that organic producers could use, so I chose not to terminate either of my cover crops with a synthetic herbicide. I wanted this to be an option for organic producers. So no herbicide use in this one. I allow them to naturally terminate, and that as well will come into play as we begin to discuss results. After my oats terminate around mid-June, I go ahead and put out a cover crop of buckwheat, and it usually grows well into August, and it terminates, and then I'm able to go ahead and put the oats in again. My fourth treatment is an herbicide option. I won't go into great detail on it, but I do have a pre-emergent and a post-emergent herbicide for this treatment. My pre-emergence is called Caseron. The active ingredient is diclobenil. I put it on an early spring, usually around mid-March. And then my post-emergence herbicide is glufosinate, a glufosinate product called Reckon. And I apply it, I do a recurring application with it when weeds reach about 4 inches in height throughout the growing season. I'll do a reapplication of the glufosinate herbicide. So that one, neither one of those are organic herbicides. There are some organic herbicides that I get questions about often, but I don't have an organic option with herbicides featured in this study. My last two treatments are managed control. The managed control is entirely hand weeded. I use a hoe to do some hand weeding on it, and then I pull a lot of weeds as well to keep it weed free. This is the ideal growing conditions for our elderberries. With the managed control, we expect to see the greatest yield, the greatest production, the greatest plant performance. That's kind of the idea behind that scientific managed control in this study. I also have an unmanaged control, which I don't touch at all. I let the weeds go crazy in that one. And it's on the other end of the spectrum. That one should ideally do the poorest across most of our response variables. Every now and then, I do have one of my treatments kind of jump past or behind my managed or unmanaged control, and that's definitely notable when we see something like that happen.